In the real world, in this style of plug, the likelihood is when you strip it apart, you see these are slightly longer than you'd see. You'd see like a tube over the top of the conductor. So you're not seeing that fine stranded class 5 conductor that we've got here. You're seeing a solid, effectively a solid tube, and that's a ferrule. We're taking off the inner PVC around our conductors. Again, would be great if we had something like this. We can see 0.75 to 1.5 and 2.5. We could just simply bring it in, squeeze, and hopefully if we get it in the right place, just pull it off. Just do that again, prove it wasn't a fluke. Look how easy that is to strip off the PVC on the conductors. And also you can use a pair of side cutters. This is hard, and I've showed this before in other videos. If I press too hard, and I'm gonna strip this one off, I just shorten it. Well, that's no good if I need it a desired length. So it's all about pressing the right amount of strength, but I don't wanna lose any of those fine strands of copper, that class 5 conductor. You see they're all there. So again, practice is the way to do it, isn't it? So snip these two off. Using a pair of side cutters, it's the right amount of pressure, and just pull away, and you can see we haven't lost those. Or we can attempt to use our knife. This takes a little bit of skill, because obviously we don't wanna press too hard because of those fine strands on the copper. We don't wanna cut ourselves. So I've gone round, trying to feel for it. And then sometimes you can pull it away with your hands. Sometimes you take a pair of pliers and you can just pull it off like that. And again, it's just checking that you haven't got any of those coming away. I don't want them all going on the bench. They're all still attached. So we've got a choice of tools that we can use there in order to remove the PVC insulating material around these class 5 conductors. This is obviously flat, so we can use this style of strippers as well. Watch this. So I put my flex in. Pull it away, I can take off the outside, bring it in again, and I can strip it off of my conductors. So that's incredibly easy. We've seen those before for twin and earth cables, but as this is flat cables, you can also use them on this style of stripper. So that was super easy as well. That leads me into the next thing, which is what I call improving the electrical connection with a ferrule. So these little copper tubes, I know they don't look copper because they're not copper in color, but if I bring in another cable here, they do look a little bit more coppery. So on that one, so that is a copper tube to improve the electrical connection. So when you screw into class 5 conductors, obviously it can weaken those individual strands. So how can you improve it? And you sometimes see it when you take apart a plug top off an appliance that you've bought, that actually there's little tubes on the conductors, they're ferrules. So it's a gentle twist. It needs to be longer than we need it. So slightly longer than I need it. Gentle twist, bring in the appropriate size ferrule, and then I've got to hope that I can see this to get it on. So my eyes are not great, so just get that end right. Bring in our ferrule, and then hopefully that will go down over the conductors. Wind it down. You should have a couple of strands, a couple of mil of strands poking out the end, so that tube's on. Bring in your ferrule crimping tool, put it in, and we crimp it up. And we can see there we've improved that electrical connection. In other words, now we're almost screwing into what is a solid copper tube rather than those fine stranded ones. And you often see those in the manufacturer's end of a plug. So check out that video. I'll leave a link for it in the description.